can't give up now. Can't give up now. Whether you are here, you are in the verge of giving up concerning something, but God has sent me to tell you today that you can't give up now. I know you have tried, but you can't give up now because you are closest to your breakthrough than ever before. In the book of Mark chapter 5, 25 to 34, it's a pretty long reading for a morning service like this. Mark 5, 25 to 34, you will read the account of the woman with the issue of blood, who has suffered many things, that if it were to be some people, that would be the end. But she still had in her heart, let me try one more time. Let me reach out again. I'm praying for somebody. To this service, you're reaching out.
Amen.
And God will meet you at the point of your
need.
And a certain woman which had an issue of blood, 12 years. Continue, sir. And has suffered many things of many physicians and has spent all, they did not even say part, all that she had and was nothing better, but rather grew worse. When she had heard of Jesus, came in the place behind and touched his garment. Poor girl. Touched his garment into Paul. Oh my God. Mark chapter 5. We started from 25. Let me just paraphrase what happened. That person needs to touch somebody's garment. Inside that place. But he touched, you know the story. He touched the garment and all of a sudden, the issue got dry. You know, in life, there are ups and downs. And there's nobody that is so good that has all the ups all the time. Forget about how people look. Forget about the pastor, the bishop, and the president, or whoever the people that we are looking up to most of the time. There is nobody so good that does not have bad times. Jesus Christ had his own fair share of it. Regardless of how sometimes we have this facade. But that is life. That is just life. A typical day is made of the daytime and the nighttime, and God actually created it like that. Without the night, the day is not complete. Meaning that everybody has his own fair share. The only thing is that when you are going through your night season, you should have at the back of your mind that it will not end like this. Morning will come. That's why the Bible says in the book of Psalm 30 verse 5, Psalm 30 verse 5, though weeping may endure for what? A night, God will come in the morning.
Joy
will always come. Troubled times are not meant to last forever. If you don't give up before the morning time, the thing is that many people give up before their morning time. That is why it now appears and say, this person did not really have a breakthrough at the end of the day. God will not allow a day to be without breaking forth into the world. So there are ups and downs. But sometimes some people experience more of down than ups in their life. Whenever somebody is experiencing that, that's no more normal life anymore. That is living below the limit that God has already given to the person. Living below the life limit. And there are some people, their life story, they are permanently down. Not that they experience more down than up, that we just talked now. They are permanently down, those ones. We can't say that they are living below the limit. But I can tag those people's life as the living dead. They are alive, but they are not really experiencing anything about the goodness of life. But in some people's cases, the reason why it's like that is that they don't make any efforts to have a change in their life. But thank God for all everybody that has come. If you don't have it at the back of your mind that you want a change in your life, you will not come apart from coming to worship God. But some people, they don't make any effort at all. Just like the man by the pool of Bethesda in the book of John chapter 5 verse 4. John chapter 5 verse 4. He was there for 38 years. And the Bible said that the angel will come at a particular season to stir up the water. That anybody that will plunge into the pool first, whatever the sickness, it does not matter what the doctor has said, it does not matter whether they call it incurable, that whatever the sickness, by the time the angel will stir it, the person will be made up. And this guy has been there 38 years. Being there for 38 years means that the person has understanding of when the angel will come. Because they said a certain season. That means that the season does not change every year. He had information. But the reason why some people don't get changes in their life is that they don't convert their information or revelation to action. Even he could not really move very well. But the Bible said that he was telling Jesus, when I am coming, meaning that he will see how he could still move a little bit, but maybe not fast, or maybe drag himself a little bit. But by the virtue of the angel having a particular time of coming, over 38 years, he said that I missed it last year, I missed it today. This particular year, he's already coming to mail. Let me move in advance to the beside the pool. So that I will just roll myself into the pool by the time the angel stirs the water at that time. Many people have information, but they don't work on it. They hear the word of God. They know the house of God, but they don't know the God of the house. They know the time that we have the first service, second service, third service, fourth service, and if you go digging, they can tell you everything about what is happening, but they are not doing anything with the word that is being given unto them. What converts your information to action is meditation. Without meditation, that's why God was telling Joshua in the book of Joshua chapter 1 verse 8, Joshua said that you will be careful to meditate on this word so that you will be able to do. The doing power comes from meditation. When you are able to ponder and to think deep concerning what you have heard, the power to want to comply will enter into you. Many people just hear the word and glory be to God, and they just go away. But that will not be your portion in the name of Jesus. So there are some people, they don't make effort. But what do we see about people that have made several efforts? Like this woman. It's not that she did not make any efforts. Even so that she has spent all on not just one physician, on physicians. And whenever a person is going through a particular situation, there will be so many suggestions from different places. And trying to get the person to change. And it is frustrating when you are acting to many suggestions, but you are not seeing solution. And the tendency is to just relax and to just give up. But this woman, after she has spent all, she had nothing again. But she did something. She said within herself, I can't give up now. As long as you are alive, you are still breathing, never accept any negative condition as the final. Let me repeat that statement. As long as you are alive and you are still breathing, never accept any negative condition as being final. It is temporary. Anything can happen at any time in God and with God. You don't have to see the sign that is about to come, it's coming, let me wait. No, it can come at any point in time. In the book of 32nd Kings chapter 3 or so, 2nd Kings chapter 3, I think it should be 14 or so, that the prophet was telling the people that they will not see the rain, but they will see the manifestation. This woman has tried on and on, but something in Apostle Paul said something in Ephesians chapter 6 verse 13. Ephesians 6:13 said that, after you have done all, then what should you do? Stand. I've done Lord. I've prayed all the prayer that I could pray. I've given all the giving that I could give. I have gone to after. Don't relax. Don't give away your faith. Just ensure that your faith is intact. There is something about faith that will get you anything that you have lost, or that will get you what you have missed in your life. If you lose everything, don't lose your faith. No, the Apostle Paul said that I have fought a good fight, but I have. There is one thing that he now said. He said, I've kept the faith. He lost many things, but he said that I will not allow my faith to be lost. I could lose my job. I could lose everything. I could even lose spouse. I could lose children. But I must not lose my faith. And that was the same testimony of Job. Once you don't lose that your faith, you will get everything in double back. Like amen. God was talking to Jesus Christ was talking to Peter, just like we read yesterday, in Luke chapter 22, 31 and 32. He said, Satan desires to have you, but I have prayed for you that your faith will not fail you. He did not say, I pray for you that he will not tempt you. He did not say, I pray for you that you will not fall. I won't pray that you will not fall. But I will pray that regardless of what will happen to you, your faith in me will still be intact. Once you can get to that point that your faith, you will not allow your faith to be shaken, then you will get everything back. There was a particular time, Nigeria played a match, Russia. Russia did Nigeria 4-0 in the first half. At that point in time, in fact, many Nigerians, you know, sometimes we are very special people. Watching the band, many people stop watching. It's like abusing them. Sometimes those days, when they will be, Nigeria will be watching match, and the supporters thought they will not be supporting, they will be saying woo-woo to their own people, because they can't imagine themselves. I can, what are we supporting? They will not be supporting any. Please, they say woo hey, hey, to their own people. I don't know what will not be supporting. So at 4-0, but I guess that when they went for the recess, their coaches or whoever was in charge must have told them, you can't give up now. That is what God is telling you now. You can't give up now. It's not over. You see half time, half of the time to play. And somehow, must have spoken to them. Blessed is the person that is weak in faith that God will send his servant to come and speak to. That was the kind of thing that Mary was spoken to by the angel, the servant of God. Said, blessed are thou. You may not see how the sign will be. She said, how will it be? Said, the fact that I'm speaking to you, there is power that is moving from the words that is entering into you. Because let me say that the words that I speak to you, they are not just ordinary words. They are spirit and they are life. And they will convert whatever situation into even glorious one in your life in the name of Jesus. And they came for the second half. By the time they came for the second half, 4-1, Nigeria return one. Now people did not really, they wanted to shout that 4-1, how many goals go. Then before they knew it, again, 4-2. These people are doing, okay, let's see. At least the disgrace is smaller now. before they knew 4-3. Before they knew 4-4. And they now went into penalty. And Nigeria won. Come and see the way street in Lagos. The people that say these people that say these people are correct people, they are correct people. I prophesy into your life. In any area of your life that you have gone down, you are going up. Amen. But you can't give up now. The Bible says that she still came in the prayer. I can imagine she'll be weak. A woman that is losing blood for 12 years, she will even look number one, look weak, and she will be weak. But as she was able to press two men that were around Jesus Christ and touch the end, and she said within herself, if only I can just hear the word of God today, if only I would just believe whatever he said. I don't know whether my situation is so bad, but if only I could just touch the end of the garment. And Jesus Christ said that somebody had touched me. No matter people were around him. It's possible for some people to be coming to church and not be able to touch Jesus Christ. But it's possible for somebody here to say that, I know that today my coming will not be in vain. God looks at how you are thinking in your heart to deliver what you need. And Jesus Christ said, somebody had touched me. The disciples said that, with all these people that are here, he said, no, it's somebody else that has made up her mind or his mind that I will not leave this place until I will tell God that particular thing and I will tell him the way I want it to be done. And I know he's not a liar. He will do my own. See, I can hear what this person is thinking. And I'm going to settle her. I prophesy into your life that before you leave this place today, you shall be settled. Jesus. And at the end of the day, Jesus Christ made a statement that tomorrow I'm still wondering. And after that, the power of God that actually healed, Jesus Christ that healed. But Jesus Christ said, thy faith has made you. It's not me. My power has always been there. Other people are not getting into the power. But something that you did not allow yourself to lose. You have lost blood, you have lost money. But because of this faith that things will turn around for me positively, it has turned things around. And you know what? In the book of Mark chapter 5, 27, as we close, maybe I will call this part one, because we still need to go further. Mark 5, 27, you have said that when she heard of Jesus Christ, she came in the press, meaning that hearing the word of God is what makes your faith to be alive. Don't get to the point that you'll be so discouraged that you don't want to come to church, that you don't want to open your Bible, that you don't want to hear or listen. Don't get to that point. When you are getting to that point, the devil is trying to remove you from the scene. But once you keep on hearing, in the book of Romans chapter 10, verse 17, Romans 10, 17, faith coming by what? Hearing and hearing. Don't be tired of hearing. As you keep on hearing, you are feeding your faith. And once your faith is alive, I tell you, there's nothing that you don't have now that you will not eventually have. She lost everything, but she did not lose her faith. Apostle Paul said, I have kept my faith. He lost the beating, they put him in prison, but he did not allow his faith. He was telling them in prison, bring the Bible for me, bring the books. He just wanted to keep on hearing the positive thing that God can do it. There's nothing God cannot do. I am more than conqueror. As you keep on hearing that your spirit man is being fed, and from your spirit man, he will start connecting you with your helper. I'm prophesying into your life today that regardless of what you have gone through, you are going up. Yeah. I decree wherever your helpers are all over the world, let them connect with you. Yeah. That thing that you have turned very hard, God said, and the God of all flesh, is there anything too hard? Let it be divinely settled. Yeah. In the area that you have failed, succeed. Let whatever has brought heaviness to your heart. That person, there is somebody here that is listening to me. Your heart is heavy. Whatever that issue is, let the mighty God that I serve, mighty God, the creator of heaven and earth, step into that situation for you. Before the end of this day, let it be resolved. Write your feet and say, Father, I hear your word. I believe your word. Be unto me according to your word. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Bless everyone. Can't give up now. That was what the woman was saying. Can't give up now. I must reach out again. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Father, thank you for your word that you have spoken to whoever you have spoken it to. We have received your word. Let your word become flesh in our life. Amen. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.